another topic would be weather. So right now we're at a pretty hot sunny day. We recently had a big heat wave where we were in the upper 90s and even hit 100 in some places. So if your yard is naturally shady, it's still a chance that your birds might get stressed about the heat. When the temperatures go over 85 even, they can become heat stressed and they'll often start panting and their beaks will just be slightly open. Sometimes people say, oh, it looks cute, they're panting. And it's normal that you see a dog pant. But if you think about cats at all, it's very rare that they pant and it's only when they're heat stressed. So whenever your chicken's beak is open and they're panting, know that it's pretty serious. And if you can get a fan out there or improvise any additional shade, it's really important. That's also something that I had not thought of before. I think because we tend to get cold in temperatures that are, you know, we don't want to sleep outside sometimes, even if it's 60s, much less when it's 30 or if it drops into the teens. But the chickens have these feathers and this downy fluff, and they stay really cozy at night. In the Pacific Northwest, they generally don't need insulation, though you could add it just to balance temperature, and they generally don't need any additional heat in their coop at night. In the summertime, that's the key time that you really want to protect them, and a fan would be the main thing to get some moving air will help cool them off. You want to make sure that they've got access to their favorite dust bath spot because they like to roll around in dirt and sand and get it in between their feathers, and that will also help them cool off. You want to make sure that there's as much water present. So we've used buckets that we actually use for our goat waterer. We realized the chickens drank out of. You could have a shallow bottom of a plant tray bottom, anything extra that there could be water in that they could either walk through if it's really shallow or that they can drink out of, so that if they're kind of dazed and they're not doing so well and moving around, that there's water really close by. Another thing when it's really hot out that you could do is also to make a little bit of a wet mash for them, where you take their mash feed or their pelleted feed, add a little water. You can even add a little bit of yogurt just to make it extra desirable, some little chopped greens, and then put that in a feed pan. Again, a plant tray bottom or even a pie tin could work, though they can tip those over sometimes because they're smaller. But if you have the water more on one side, then they'll drink some of that and they'll eat the food. Because sometimes if it gets really hot and you were to think about just eating dry cereal, it's not very desirable. And even drinking your water sometimes seems like a chore. But if you're eating something, then you'll usually drink some water. So it's a way to get them to do both things and stay healthier. We have always ended up having really sunny situations for our chickens. So when it gets really hot out, don't care what anybody thinks. Grab cardboard, towels, tarps, tent, rain flies. Anything you can to improvise shade wherever you can for as much of the day as possible, your chickens will be super grateful. As far as the winter goes, the things to keep an eye on again would be water. Water is their most important nutrient, so you're always trying to make sure it's not too hot and it's also not freezing. So sometimes just taking your water in at night in the winter when it gets really cold is enough to keep it from freezing. There are metal, looks like pie pans that are upside down that you can get as a heater base for your waterer. So if you think you're going to be out of town or your work schedule might be something that means you might not get around and you have a long day away from the house, you could always get a heating element for your waterer. There's also heating elements that go in buckets. And then that's something you might want to think about getting when it's really hot out. Demand that your feed store or go online and try to get one when it's the opposite time of year if you know that you think you'll need to keep their water from freezing by buying something. It tends to be like fans. When it's super hot out, everyone suddenly needs a fan and they can run out, versus off times of year. As far as the ideas of heating their coop goes, one thing to think about would be if you were staying at a hotel, you're not paying for the electricity, you might be on vacation, so you might have the room really warm and cozy. It's the winter, so why not be really toasty? All of a sudden there's a fire drill, you're just wearing little shorts, not very much pajamas, you have to run outside, it's really cold, it might be windy, it might be snowing, it's gonna feel really shocking to your body. Whereas if your house stays moderately warm, but you don't use so much heat, and you're just protected from big gusts of wind, if you have to go outside, you're generally not going to be as shocked by the outside temperatures because your inside temperature is not so hot. So with a chicken, it's really important to remember that if their house is too warm, they might enjoy it, they also might get stressed out, but then the difference between when they get up in the morning and go outside is much more shocking on their bodies. And so we're always trying to keep them as peaceful and calm as possible and away from any stress. So having a more moderate temperature in their house is much better. Something that you can do, kind of similar to when it's really hot out, is that you can improvise ways to block the wind. So in that you might add tarps for shade in the summer. In the winter, you might take some clear plastic, whether that's the rolls of plastic or fiberglass boards or anything like that, and actually make some things that keep rain off while still letting the sunshine in, and that also block any prevailing winds that are coming at your chicken coop. They'll still go out. Our chickens end up, it looks like they're at sea sometimes when there's windy, rainy storms. They'll all be out together and like hunker down and look like they're loving the wind. But if you give them some spots where they can stay dry, it'll keep their dust bath area dry, gives them a place to retreat to and stay cozy. And as far as their house goes, you want always for there to be some good ventilation so things don't get too moist inside their house. But at the same time, you don't want there to be giant gusts of wind that in the summer might keep them cool, but in the winter might be too much. So you can always improvise in the winter as well and add things on.